bow to you, Allah, Allah, you are my Lord. I bow to you, Allah, 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 you are my Lord. I bow to you. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise is due to Allah, and may peace and blessings be upon the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family and his companions. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, welcome to another episode of the basics of a Muslim's belief. Insha'Allah ta'ala, after hearing the meaning of La ilaha illallah, and the conditions of La ilaha illallah, and how La ilaha illallah is the statement which encapsulates the purpose of our life, and after hearing the opposite of La ilaha illallah, we now come to that second part of the testimony of faith. The testimony that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and that our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. And it's the second part, our testimony regarding the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that we want to talk about in this episode today with the permission of Allah azza wa jalla. When we say that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah, what do we mean by that statement? What does that statement imply? What are the conditions or the pillars, if you like, of saying that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah? In reality, when we read through the ayat of the Quran and we read through the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, things he said and he did and he approved of and his description of him, we find that believing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah revolves around three things. The first is that you obey him in what he commanded you to do and what he prohibited you from doing. And this is mentioned frequently throughout the Quran. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولُ. Obey Allah and his messenger. Obey Allah and obey the messenger. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the messenger. For you to say that you believe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the messenger of Allah entails that you are willing to obey him. And that you agree that as Allah's messenger, you must obey him in what he commanded you to do and what he prohibited you from doing. And we know that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not used to speak from his own desire. Allah azza wa jal says at the beginning of Surah An-Najm, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Doesn't speak from his own desire. It's simply a revelation that is revealed. And we know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to one of the companions, write, as in write down what I say. For by Allah, nothing comes out of here except the truth. And he pointed to his mouth. Nothing comes out of here except the truth. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, indeed, what the messenger of Allah has made haram is like what Allah has made haram. أَلَا إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ مِثْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, what the messenger of Allah has forbidden is like what Allah has forbidden. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So the first meaning when we say that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah is that we agree to obey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then that we believe in what he told us. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us about many things. He informed us about Allah azza wa jal, informed us about the angels, he informed us about the previous scriptures that we don't have access to, he informed us about the previous prophets that we've never seen, he informed us about the last day, He informed us about what will happen on the Day of Judgment. He informed us about what will happen in the world before the Day of Judgment comes. All of these things we have no way of scientifically testing the truth of what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in them, or for the vast majority of cases. Until those things happen, or until we see those things with our own eyes. But the part that I'm talking about of saying that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah is that you believe him in those things, and indeed you believe him in everything that he told you about. So when he says that he was taken on a night journey, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, from Mecca to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, and from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa that he ascended to the heavens, and that he reached Sidratul Muntaha, the highest and most lofty place in paradise with Jibreel, and Jibreel said to him that this is as far as my Lord has permitted me for me to go. And that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went beyond that, and he saw the light that veiled Allah azza wa jal. This story is something that you believe as much as you believe in your own existence. And you don't come and say that, how can we believe in this? How can a man do this? If he was to ascend past the atmosphere, he wouldn't be able to breathe. How was he able to reach this? We know that the universe is like this. If a person travels this far, Einstein said this about the relativity and this about the light, and if it bended, this would have happened to him, and he would have... Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said is true. And Allah azza wa jal is more than able, subhanahu wa ta'ala, of taking his Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the heavens in the way that he chose to do, jalla wa ala. And there is nothing that is difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you hear this story, you believe in it. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells you about the battles and the fighting that is going to go on at the end of time, and he tells you about the Dajjal, and he tells you about the matters of the grave and the Day of Judgment, you don't say, how can this happen? We haven't seen it. How can a person be punished in the grave? Because when we exhume the body, we just see bones. Allah Azza wa Jal is more than able of concealing. Allah Azza wa Jal is more than able concealing this from you. But the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, and so it's true. So part of your belief that he is the messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is that you believe in what he told us. And the final pillar, or the final fundamental principle and meaning of saying that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the messenger of Allah, is that we only worship Allah in the way that he showed us. Let me ask you a question. If I were to say to you today, you know, our prayer is something beautiful, but Fajr, it's too short. Two rak'ah is not enough. We should pray four rak'ah so that we get near to Allah. What would you say to me, the brothers and sisters at home? What would you say to me if I said to you that we should make Fajr four rak'ah instead of two? You'd say to me, no, Muhammad, you can't do it, because the Prophet ﷺ prayed them as two, so we pray them as two. If I told you that I don't think this is a very nice way of praying, you know, to keep your hands like this, you should put your hands on your head. You should pray with your hands on your head. What would you say to me? You say, no, Muhammad, because the Prophet ﷺ told us to pray like this, and he didn't tell us to pray like this. So we can only worship Allah the way that he sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam showed us to pray. And this is, in summary, the meaning of our statement that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Before we look at some of the details and some of the evidences for this, and some of the ayat and the ahadith that relate to this belief, let's just speak for a moment about our need for the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah azza wa jal says that it has indeed been for you in the Messenger of Allah the best example. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. There has been for you in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the most excellent pattern for anyone who hopes in Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. And this is in surah number 33, ayah number 21. You have the most excellent example in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Without his guidance and his sunnah, we wouldn't know what to do. Just imagine for a second, Allah Azza wa Jal says, O you who believe, establish the prayer. O you who believe, seek the help of Allah in the patience and the prayer. How do we pray without the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah Azza wa Jal tells us to fast from the morning until the evening. How do we know what breaks our fast? How do we know all of the things that are not mentioned in the Quran, except with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ. Allah has commanded you, obligated that you make hajj. How do we make hajj? How do we know how to make hajj without the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The end of this part before we go for the break is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the guidance of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are in desperate need of following it. We're going to come back after a short break inshallah ta'ala. Until then, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters. We're talking about our belief. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. We said that this means that you obey him, and it means that you believe in what he told you, and it means that you only worship Allah in the way that he showed you, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Now we're going to take a moment to look at the evidence, or some of the evidences that emphasize this in the Quran. And in reality, there are many, many ayat. Look at all of the ayat that mention the messenger. Whenever you read the Quran, look at all of the ayat that mention the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and look at the commands to obey him and the prohibitions in disobeying him. But let's just take a moment to look at the command of believing in what the messenger told us. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Al-A'raf, the seventh surah of the Quran, in ayah number 158, say, O Muhammad, O mankind, indeed I am the messenger of Allah to you all, from him to whom belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. There is no God worthy of worship except him. He gives life and causes death. So believe in Allah and his messenger, the unlettered prophet who believes in Allah and his words, and follow him so that you might be guided. This ayah contains the command to believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and believe in what he told you, and the command to follow him as well. And Allah Azza wa Jal says in the 48th surah, in the 9th ayah, that you people may believe in Allah and his messenger, and honor him and respect the Prophet, and exalt Allah in the morning and the afternoon. And Allah Azza wa Jal says in surah number 64, ayah number 8, so believe in Allah and his messenger and the Quran which we have sent down, and Allah is all acquainted with what you do. But the Quran doesn't just tell us to believe in the messenger. The Quran tells us the crime of disbelieving in the messenger. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah An-Nisa, fourth surah, ayah number 136, O you who have believed, believe in Allah and his messenger and the book that we sent down to his messenger and the scripture which we sent down before. And whoever disbelieves in Allah, his angels, his books, his messengers, and the last day has certainly gone far astray. So not only is Allah Azza wa Jal commanding you to believe, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you the punishment and the severe state of the person who does not believe. And of course, we must be careful that while every one of us, both myself and the brothers and sisters at home, inshallah, claim to believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we must be careful that we don't contradict that belief with our intellect. Like we said before, how can this happen? Because I can't see it, I can't understand it. Or by making analogies, or by saying it just doesn't feel right to me, or using politics or any other thing to contradict the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rather, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam should be foremost, and it should be the fundamental basis and the fundamental guidelines that the Muslim uses to regulate their life and to worship Allah Azza wa Jal as He deserves to be worshipped. So this belief, we believe in everything that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, means that we can't contradict it with any of the things that we mentioned. We can't contradict it with our intellect, or we can't contradict it with how we feel. We can't contradict it with any of our culture or any of these issues. Rather, we hold the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to be above everything else, and that we put it before everything else, and that we use this as our methodology and our way of life, that we worship Allah Azza wa Jal with as He deserves to be worshipped, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for our obedience to the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then some of the ayat that command us to obey the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam include the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 32, say, obey Allah and the Messenger. But if they turn away, then indeed Allah does not like the disbelievers. And the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 59, O you who have believed, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and those in authority over you. And if you disagree in something, refer it to Allah and the Messenger if you really believe in Allah and the last day. That is the best way and the best in result. And the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Al-Anfal, ayah number 20, O you who have believed, obey Allah and His Messenger and do not turn from Him when you hear His order. And in the 24th Surah, ayah number 54, say, obey Allah and obey the Messenger. But if you turn away, then upon Him is only that duty with which He has been charged, and upon you is that which with you have been charged. And if you obey Him, you will be rightly guided. And there is nothing that is obligatory upon the Messenger except for the responsibility of clearly giving the message. And in the 59th Surah, ayah number 7, and whatever the Messenger has given you, take it, and whatever he has forbidden you from, refrain from it. And fear Allah, indeed Allah is severe in penalty. And like we said, it's not just a command to obey the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's not just a command to obey the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and to have obedience to him, but the prohibition of disobeying the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And whoever opposes the Messenger after guidance has become clear to him and follows a way other than that of the believers, we will give him what he has taken and drive him into hell, and evil it is as a destination. In Surah An-Nisa, which is the 4th Surah, ayah number 150. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, that is because they opposed Allah and His Messenger. And whoever opposes Allah and His Messenger, indeed Allah is severe in penalty. Surah Al-Anfal, ayah number 13. And in the 24th Surah, ayah number 63, so let them beware, those who dissent from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's order, lest a fitna strike them, a trial or a severe punishment. A trial or a severe punishment. And some of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, the trial that a person will be afflicted with when they disobey the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a trial of falling into shirk, falling into polytheism. What does it mean to obey our Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? This covers four aspects. It covers obeying him in those things which he commanded us to do, obligations, the fard, we have to obey him in. And it contains obeying him in the prohibitions that he forbade us from. And that's the haram, we have to keep away from it. And it includes the recommendation of obeying him in those things he recommended, the mustahabbat, the recommended things. And that's not that we have to do it, but that it's more complete. The more we do of the recommendations of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the closer we will come to achieving the meaning of Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And to try to avoid doing those things that he disliked. Again, this is not an obligation for you, but the more you do to avoid the things that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam disliked, the more you fulfill the true meaning of the statement that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the Messenger of Allah. And in this, if you look at the companions, radiallahu anhum, they were the best example of this. They did all that the Prophet ﷺ commanded them to do. They avoided all that the Prophet ﷺ commanded them to not to do. They did their best to do as much as they could of the recommended actions and to avoid as much as they could of the disliked actions. And as for the issue of following the Prophet ﷺ, we talked about it briefly at the beginning of the episode, and likewise, inshallah ta'ala, now we'll talk about it for a few moments. We are required to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we are prohibited from doing anything that is in opposition to his guidance sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this included in this, and that's why we made it a third category found within the Quran and the Sunnah, is that we are forbidden from worshipping Allah in any way other than the way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us how to do. Ibn Mas'ud, the noble companion radiallahu anh, he said, follow and do not innovate, for your needs have been met. Follow the sunnah, don't make anything new, because you have everything there that you need. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 106, on the day that some faces will turn white and some faces will turn black. And as for those whose faces turn black, to them it will be said, did you disbelieve after your belief? Then taste the punishment of what you used to reject. Ibn Abbas, the noble companion and the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, this is when the faces of the followers of the sunnah and the jama'ah, the united body of the Muslims, will radiate with whiteness, and the faces of the followers of innovation and division will be darkened. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was told to say in the Quran, in Surah Al-Kahf, ayah number 103 and 104, say, O Muhammad, shall I inform you of the greatest losers as to their deeds? They are those whose effort, what is lost in worldly life, while they think they are doing good with their work. Ibn Abbas said, they are the people of innovation as well as the Jews and the Christians. And Ali radiallahu anh said that they are the Haruriyah, i.e. the Khawarij, those people who rebelled from the Muslims against Ali radiallahu anh during his time. And from this is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa rad, whoever does an action that's not in accordance with what we brought will have it rejected. And from this is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Abu Dawood and At-Tirmidhi, beware of newly invented matters, i.e. in the religion. For every newly invented matter is in an innovation, and every innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. And Ibn Umar, the noble companion radiallahu anhuma, said, every innovation is misguidance, even if the people think that it is something good. So in conclusion, we obey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in what he commanded us, we believe in what he told us about, and we only worship Allah Azza wa Jal in the way that he showed us, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. It's all we have time for. And until next time, I leave you in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah, Allah, you are my Lord.